Hello, in this video we're going to replace the fuel valve. And today I'm going to show you how. Okay, right here we have a fuel valve for a scooter. It's also called a padcock. Right here. So this one is one way for the vacuum line to open up the padcock and let the valve open and let the gas go through. This one is the line that comes from the tank, the fuel tank. And this is the line that goes to your carburetor, okay? Now there is a membrane, a diaphragm inside that opens up when the vacuum pulling, okay? So this one allowed the gas to go in. Pretty cheap item, but after a while, in these scooters, with the ethanol in there is in the gas, they will get damaged. So the rubber inside will get damaged. So they will start to leak. If they start to leak, it's better if you buy a new one. Why? Because if this one fail, there is a problem. This, all the gas that goes through here, and it keeps leaking all night or all day when you don't use the scooter, it's gonna overflow the carburetor. The carburetor has a floater inside, you know? So when it goes up, close up the line that comes with the gas from the padcock in the gas tank. But if the carburetor fell, at that point, the carburetor start to overflow inside your engine. And what is going to happen, there is going a lot of gas gonna go inside your cylinder. When it goes inside your cylinder, it's gonna slightly leak inside the oil. When it leaks inside the oil, there's another chain reaction that your oil is gonna start to smell like, for sure, fuel. And that fuel, what's gonna happen, that is going to damage all the gasket on your scooter, inside your motor, inside your engine. So changing this one will help a lot with the fact that your seals or your gaskets inside your motor, they're not gonna get damaged in the long way, okay? Now, one day it's better if you change this one to a switch. Instead to have a padcock fuel valve, having a switch is a lot safer. But this one is a comfortable way, is like an easy way to keep the fuel close. So this one is okay for now. In the future, it's better if you put the switch. So you close it, and you know that it's gonna be staying closed for a long time, okay? So no fuel is gonna go through. Okay, I will show you right now where the fuel padcock or fuel valve is located and how you can change it. I will show you that right now. Okay, the location of the padcock or fuel valve is right inside here, okay? Next to the key of your seat. So the padcock valve is located right here. So one line comes from the tank and the other line goes to the carburetor. Now there is a little center hose right here, connector, that this one will connect it to the vacuum line, okay? So if you like to open this part right here, you're very welcome. You have to remove the rear rack for the back, okay? There is a lot of screws down here, the screws where you put your feet, and then you're gonna open up this part right here. But that will take you a long time. The other way that is a little easier, you open up the seat, and you go find this one, that is the port petco valve, that is inside here. But the problem that you don't really have too much space there. So, but you're going to need a 10 millimeter socket with a wrench to remove the padcock, okay? I will show you right now how to do it. So you open up the seat. You open up the seat. You remove the fuel cap. You have two 10 millimeter bolts down here on the top of your inside, okay? And you have two 10 millimeter on the bottom of your inside part of the scooter. After you've done this one, you can remove this part right here. You can put this cap, the fuel cap, make sure you put it back, because the gas might splash in your eyes, okay? So put it right here and close it, okay? Okay, your petcock valve right here, the fuel valve, is located on the left side of the scooter, on the inside. Sometimes they broke because they're not really good quality, and sometimes they broke. Now they have one line that comes from the tank. They have one line that is the vacuum line that's allowed this valve to open. There is one line that goes to your carburetor that brings the fuel to the carburetor, okay? Okay, this one is going to be the new valve that I'm going to put in. This side right here goes to the tank, this side right here goes to the carburetor, and the top part, the center part, goes to the vacuum line, okay? So this one will open up the valve when it's the time, okay? Now, if you wanna make sure, don't switch these two around, because if you put this one reverse, the gas keep going through, it's gonna go through, it's not gonna stop here, okay? So try to blow some hair on this side for your mouth, and you try, okay? If the air doesn't go through, this is the side that goes to the tank, okay? This is the side that goes to the carburetor. So if you blow some hair, this one in the reverse side goes through, okay? But this one close up, okay? Now to put this one on is really easy. You just take all the connection that you have in your old valve right here, and you're gonna place it on the new valve. Now, you have to remove this bolt that is down here, that is a 10 millimeter, okay? To remove this one, it's kind of like a little bit of problem, because you have the frame of the body, you have the body of your scooter, so to remove that part, you have to pull slightly the plastic out, okay? To remove that one. Okay, right here, unfortunately this one is broken, but to replace it, you need to put this one down here. You kind of pull the plastic a little bit out, and you're going to unscrew this bolt right here. The bolt that is down here, okay? So you just have to unscrew it a little bit. Now you have to be a little bit patient, okay? Because you can remove all the plastic all around the scooter on the left side. So you can remove this part right here. Or you just take a little bit more time, be patient, and remove the bolt, okay? This is the small bolt that is 10 millimeter that you have right here at your fuel valve, okay? Now you can place the new one right here. You place it like that, okay? And you can place it like that. You can put the bolt in the back, or you can even try to put it in the front. Instead to go in the back, you can put it on the front, because you have enough room between the inside of your scooter and the frame. So if you place it right here, it's a lot better for you next time that you want to replace it. That's my suggestion to you. Now first place this valve right there, and then you're going to hook up all the connection, okay? Make sure you tighten it pretty good so it's not gonna go anywhere, okay? At this point, you can take the very fast, slightly squeezing the hose that comes from the tank, and you're gonna connect it to the back side of the padcock. Very fast. You can slightly pinch the hose. You can slightly pinch the hose to make sure Now, the next one, you have to put the vacuum line right here in the center. There is a little tighten to tie this hose. Make sure you keep it there, okay? Now, pull this one out, and you can place it in the new fuel valve right there. And this one, you can squeeze and tie it right here, or if you have a zip tie, you can put a zip tie too. Okay, now the last one is the connection that goes to your carburetor. Okay, this is the connection that goes to your carburetor, and you can place it right there. Okay. Now, there is a reason why I have a clear line on the line that goes to the carburetor. Because you really want to know, sometime when you do some tests with your scooter, that the gas goes freely from the tank to the carburetor. If you have a dark line like the other ones, you're not gonna see the fuel going through. So you really wanna know. That's one of the easy thing to see when you have your scooter on, or when you start in a scooter, sometimes it doesn't start. The first question is my carburetor getting any fuel? If it is getting fuel, you can see it clearly with your eyes, okay? Now right here, you can put a zip tie right here, okay? This fuel padcock valve, they're pretty inexpensive. You go online, you can buy for $5-$10, and what's going on with these ones, you can be safe, a little safer, and to know that your gas at nighttime when you leave the scooter at your house is not gonna flow all the time from the gas tank to the floor or something like that. So change this part once in a while, okay? So if you remember, maybe at 5,000 miles, you know, you can change this one. Because the problem that is the ethanol that is on your fuel that is destroying the padcock valve, fuel valve, okay? Now, let me show you something else. You know, something really interesting. I'm going to get the old valve, open up the valve and show you what's inside so you have a better idea. Okay, this is my old fuel valve. And what they do, they get damaged with the ethanol that is in the fuel, okay? So, let's see. I'm gonna try to open this up and see. I slightly open already a little bit, but okay, it's kind of hard. You know, these things are fixable, but you don't really want to get and take your time to fix it, or an hour to fix this problem, when you can buy for $5, okay? So, now let's see if I can move it right here. Okay, the inside part, there is a diaphragm. There is a diaphragm inside, and there is a spring, okay? Look, this is the side of the vacuum line right here, and there is a spring, and there is a diaphragm that is made of rubber, okay? So this part right here, with time, it loses, you know, special powers. It kind of is going to lose its flexibility. It's going to lose, you know, it's going to lose the power of closing this valve for you when you're not going with a scooter, okay? So this system is pretty simple, but it's, in the same time, it's really, sometimes makes me worry, because I really don't trust these petcock valves or fuel valves, how you want to call them. I really don't trust them. So one of those days, I'm going to do a modification on my scooter, and I'm going to place a real switch, like an off-road bike switch, you know, those ones that are really more safe than these ones, okay? But if you do a switch, you have to reroute the vacuum line, okay? So this is what you're going to find inside the fuel valve, okay? Pretty simple. Okay, right after you replace your fuel valve, you're able to put everything back. Right here, you can put everything inside. Put the cap back of the fuel. You can put the two bolts right here and two nuts at the end of your container inside the scooter, and you're done. So please make sure you drive safe with your scooter. Don't make me worry. Subscribe to my channel. Click like at any time. If you have any question, feel free to ask. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.